A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 28th June, on the front page you have Trump terms India's high tariffs on US products unacceptable. So US President Donald Trump says that he'll take up the issue with Prime Minister Narendra Modi at the G20 summit in Osaka. So the two leaders are going to meet in Osaka. Even recently we had the US Secretary of State meeting External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar too. So there are issues, trade related issues too. Tariffs and counter tariffs have been imposed by US and India. And this is Bombay High Court upholds reservation for Marathas. So Bombay High Court has now given its ruling. The 16% reservation is called unjustifiable, but it says 13% can be the maximum amount of reservation. So reservation as such has been upheld, but the cap as such has also been provided. Then this is four bank accounts of Nirav Modi's sister frozen. So this is Swiss action which came on the request of Enforcement Directorate. So Swiss bank accounts have been frozen. Then below you have Haryana Congress leader shot dead in Faridabad. So such political murders are quite often heard of now. He was actually attacked while leaving a gym, and Congress leaders have criticized the ruling BJP-led government as such on this issue. And below you have National Mission on Natural Language Translation. So this is 450 crore proposal, part of the 100-day action plan charted out by Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. So it will soon be placed before the cabinet for approval. This is natural language translation. So means it is one of the key missions also under Prime Minister's Science, Technology and Innovation Advisory Council. So it's a 100-day action plan which has been charted out. So what this mission tries to do is make science and technology accessible by facilitating access to teaching and researching material bilingually, that is in English and in one's native language, Indian language. So this is the national mission on natural languages, natural language translation. On page 7 you have council adjourned over delay in reservation for dhangars. So proceedings in the Maharashtra Legislative Assembly has been affected. It was disrupted and the house was adjourned thrice. The issue was delay in reservation for dhangars. So this has been a demand for long. So we saw Maratha reservation being upheld by Bombay High Court presently, and now demand is for providing reservation for the Dhangar community, which is a shepherd community. On the editorial page, the first editorial is at the high table. So this is regarding India getting a step closer towards having a non-permanent seat at UN Security Council. So it says India must think big now. So what are the challenges ahead for it, what it needs to undertake. So that is discussed here. Like rising China, US receding from its UN responsibilities. So India must consider how it will strengthen the multilateral world order amid frequent unilateral moves by both the world powers. The next is prudent prescription. So this is regarding RBI panel's suggestions on micro, small and medium enterprises sector. The editorial says that micro, small and medium enterprises is a crucial sector in the Indian economy. It contributes more than 28% of the GDP and about 45% to manufacturing output. So it is under stress, and suggestions given by the expert committee constituted by RBI in this context are appreciated. So this is important. Then the lead article is a democratic requirement. So this article talks of how India's brooding parliamentary opposition needs to study its historical legacy to chart the road ahead. So a strong opposition, a viable opposition is extremely essential in a democracy. So that is discussed here. The history behind opposition leaders also. Like how was it in the 1960s, 1970s and so on. And this is a policy to regulate coaching centers. So coaching institutions, it says, undermine mainstream education and impose a huge cost on students. So it says there's a need to regulate coaching centers, even in the context of the deadly fire which took place in a Surat coaching center, where students jumped off, many died during the jump and many died in the fire. So this was a ghastly incident which had come up in news. So there's a need to regulate coaching centers, and a case is made here on the issue. Then on Fridays on the op-ed page, you have this parlay coverage where a particular issue is discussed on from both sides. So the question today is, will the idea of one nation, one poll work in India? So it says the proposal will undermine the federal structure by pushing the regional parties out. So we have done many points, counterpoints on this issue. So this is a very important issue. And this is BIMSTEC, a viable option. So this talks of how, unlike SAG, BIMSTEC provides opportunities for economic, cultural and social cooperation in the region. On page 13, you have Modi and Abe discuss economy bullet train. So this is regarding India-Japan relations. Prime Minister Narendra Modi is in Osaka, Japan for the G20 summit. And India-Japan relations are also discussed here. It says they had a very constructive and detailed discussion. So this is important. On international page, an important news which is there is regarding honoring an iconic Punjab Maharaja. So this is Maharaja Ranjit Singh. His sculpture was unveiled in Lahore, Pakistan to mark his 180th death anniversary. On business page, you have SEBI tightens norms for mutual fund investments. So SEBI does not recognize funds standstill agreements with company promoters. So this is in this context. Now norms have further been tightened on investments in mutual funds. Then this is non-performing assets down, credit growth picking up. So this is RBI survey which shows that how capital infusion has helped improve capital adequacy ratio of banks. And this is government revamps WPI revision team. So this is about wholesale price index. So the government has reconstituted the working group tasked with revising the current wholesale price index. So the terms of reference of the working group include selecting the most appropriate base year, and then also regarding the index numbers of wholesale price and the producer price index in India. So the team has been revamped presently. Then this is non-banking finance company crisis separated the good from the bad, says RBI. So it says firms with strong fundamentals managed their liquidity while others perished. So this is what RBI says on the issue. And this is cut logistics cost to 9% of GDP. So India has huge logistics cost, means transportation and movement of goods, etc. So it, central government from Ministry of Commerce says that states should ensure that logistic cost is 9% of GDP. So that is currently India's logistics cost is 14% of GDP. So this is the target being set. And India's logistics costs are high compared to international costs. And on the last page, an important news is NASA to open sealed moon rock samples. So it will use new technology to study the rock samples now, which had been collected during the Apollo 15 mission of the 1960s. So this is it. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asr.com. Thank you.